sounds of the beast.
As you can see, that's the sound of the police. The memorial spot, Sean Bellway. This is the block Sean Bell was killed on. This is a picture of Danroy Henry, the young man that was murdered by the police.
I'm a member of the International People's Democratic Uhuru Movement. I'm standing here today with the Reverend Omar Wilks, and we are members of the African community who are tired of the attacks on the African community by the New York Police Department, by the police department in general around the country. We're standing here again to have the vigil for Danroy Henry, who was murdered by the police on October 17th, specifically because he was an African. And that is a particular problem that happens in the African community. We are murdered left and right with impunity, and no one suffers any consequences for our murders. I'd like to say that the police occupy the African community like an occupying army, the same way they would occupy Iraq or occupy Afghanistan. The same flash grenades that they use in Afghanistan and Iraq is the same flash grenades they use on the Indiana Jones and Detroit, Michigan. The same tactics that they used to murder Sean Bell right before he was supposed to be married is the same tactics that they use in warlike scenarios in Afghanistan, in Iraq.
First of all, I want to thank those words from Brother Feist from the Uhuru Movement. We have to have an insult level. Are you tired of hearing over and over and over and over again another of our men, women, and children have been killed by the police? We have to get fired up. We have to have an insult level. We can't sit idly by, skin and grin, turn on Oprah Winfrey, and forget about what's going on in our communities. We have a moral obligation to stand up. We have to be fired up. Because all over this country, police think that they can murder and kill our men, women, and children. Danroy Henry, who was a straight-A student, as Brother Fike just mentioned, was a good kid. He never had a record. He did the right thing. Like Sean Bell, he was doing the right thing. He went to school, college student, a student athlete, a role model in his community. His whole college community respected Danroy. On the day of Danroy's homecoming game, like any normal group of young people, after a game, the college community went to Finnegan's Grill. Danroy, after having a good time with his friends, left there. And once when he got to his car and pulled out into the fire lane, and as he was pulling out of the fire lane, there are witnesses that said that police started shooting into the car and killed Danroy. The witnesses said that the police were unjustified. They jumped onto this car and unleashed their bullets into this car that ripped into Danroy. And you know what makes this sick? You know what makes this sick? After shooting Danroy, they handcuffed him. And as Danroy was bleeding, as Danroy Henry was bleeding, they handcuffed him, put him on the ground for over 15 minutes. And you know what? You know what makes this sick? You know what makes this sick? Danroy's friends went to CPR because they saw Danroy, his life fading away. They saw the blood coming out of Danroy. They saw Danroy gasping for air. And then the police pulled out their guns on the college students, his fellow college students, and told them they cannot help Danroy. And Danroy lay there bleeding and he died. How many times police are going to continue to make excuses when they kill our men, women, and children? It's always an excuse when our officers kill our men, women, and children. And I'm here to say, stop police brutality. 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 Justice for Danroy Henry. Stop police brutality. Justice for Danroy Henry. Stop police brutality. Justice for Danroy Henry. And we're still, and there's so many parallels in this case and with the killing of Sean Bell. The police officers used the same excuse that the car backed up into the police officers. They're using the same excuses all around this country. And I'm here to say, stop police brutality. Justice for Danroy Henry. Stop police brutality. Justice for Danroy Henry. Stop police brutality. Justice for Danroy Henry. Look at what they did to Oscar Grant in California. How can you get around that? For those who saw the killing of Oscar Grant, it showed the police officer standing over Oscar Grant while he was laying on the floor and they unleashed a shot into his back. How do you justify that? The police officer said that was an accident. It's always an accident whenever police murder our men, women, and children. Why is it always an accident? Why is it always somebody else's fault? When has the police ever taken responsibility for murdering innocent men, women, and children? Ayanna Jones, a little girl in Detroit, Michigan. A sweet little 7-year-old baby laying in her bed with her grandmother. Laying in bed with her grandmother. And the police throw a flash grenade through the window, which lit her on fire. What wrong did Ayanna Jones do for a flash grenade to be thrown through the window and for her to be lit on fire? What wrong did Ayanna Jones do after being lit on fire to be shot through the head? What wrong did Ayanna Jones do for the grandmother she loved to be framed by the police? What wrong did Ayanna Jones do other than the fact she was a poor black girl that lived in Detroit, Michigan? What wrong did Danroy Henry do other than he was an aspiring college student? An aspiring college student that wanted to do the right thing. What wrong did Sean Bell do other than the fact that he wanted to marry the mother of his two children?